Today, we want to show you one great variation to help you progress your pull-ups. And maybe if you haven't gotten your first pull-up yet, this is an awesome exercise to help you work into it. This is gonna be a great way for you to have a smooth transition into the body weight pull-ups. So the setup here is we're gonna have Aaron set his hands about shoulder width apart. He's gonna scoot his feet just a little bit in front of that bar. And then from there, he's gonna act like he's sitting in a chair and try to keep as upright as possible. So we wanna stay nice and vertical here. From there, he's gonna use his feet just as much as he needs to assist him in pulling up and getting that chin in line or just above the bar, and then nice and controlled on the way down. So there's two portions of the pull-up. There's what we call the concentric movement, or just the way up, and there's the eccentric movement, so that way down. So some ways that we progress this movement is we can come up to the top and really go slow eccentric, so slow on the way down, nice and controlled, maybe count to 5 or to 7 to even push it a little bit harder. We can also come to the top, do a concentric pause, or an isometric pause, excuse me, so just holding that top position, maybe hold there for 3 to 5, nice and slow on the way down. If we want to progress that even more, we can come to the top, pause, lift our feet, hold our body weight, feet back down, then controlled on the way down. And if we really want to progress it, we can come to the top, lift our feet, and slow and controlled on that eccentric portion. So we know that we're stronger eccentrically, so we're stronger on the way down than coming up. So that will kind of allow you to utilize those muscles and gain some strength while we, you know, progress the actual pull-up. So it's a great variation to build the strength for the pull-up before you actually have the strength. So there are a couple common mistakes we see with this movement. I'd say the main one is, you know, people with their feet a little bit too far back. So that's not gonna allow you to really stay vertical through the movement. So we want those feet a little bit in front of the bar, maybe 6 inches or so. And then another thing we see is people leaning back and looking up. So we want this movement to match that pull up as much as possible. So a really great cue for this is keep your eyes forward and stay vertical, then let your butt drop straight down to the ground. Because with a pull up, we know obviously we're gonna be kind of hanging. So we wanna match that really vertical path of the pull. We can also do a couple different variations with this movement. So one, we can just switch the grip, go into a chin up, go close grip, go wide grip, anything to target different muscles or different movements. And we can also change the bar. So we can put a trap bar in there to make it a neutral grip, or even utilize TRXs, the way we can move the handles. So you just set up TRXs nice and high, but hit the movement in the exact same way. So those different variations can kind of help you to build strength in different positions or in different muscles. So we know how frustrating it can be to get your first pull-up. It's a very, very tough movement. It's advanced, and one, it's one of the hardest movements in the gym to really be great at. So one, cut yourself a break, but be consistent with the movements. You have to be consistent with variations like this that are gonna allow you quality of movement and a lot of time under tension. And it's also a great idea to add in some accessory work that's gonna help build up the muscles that will help you accomplish your first pull-up. So building up the lats, building up the biceps, the grip, and just the back in general is gonna do great things to help you progress to that pull-up.